हेलो दोस्तों, फ्लैट वाइजली आप सभी के लिए एक और असाइनमेंट लेके आ चुका है और अब हम करेंगे एकेडमिक राइटिंग एंड कंपोजिशन का, जो कि है जनरल इलेक्टिव का। तो गाइस, आप सभी नई वीडियोस के अपडेट के लिए हमारे चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करें, लाइक करें, शेयर करें और नीचे दिए गए बेल आइकन को भी प्रेस करें। अब हम स्टार्ट करते हैं हमारा क्वेश्चन। Write a critical note on the principles of academic writing. Do you think these principles should be followed for academic writing? Give reasons for your answer. तो गाइज, आंसर स्टार्ट करने से पहले, जैसे कि हम हर वीडियो में बताते हैं कि जब भी आप कोई नया असाइनमेंट शुरू करते हो तो उसके पहले पेज पे आपको नेम, SOL रोल नंबर, एग्जामिनेशन रोल नंबर, सिग्नेचर, पेज नंबर, ये सब होना चाहिए। बट साथ में जो फर्स्ट पेज होगा उस पे आपको सब्जेक्ट कोड और अपना पेपर कोड ज़रूर लिखना है। अब हम स्टार्ट करते हैं हमारा आंसर। Academic writing is any writing done to fulfill a requirement of a college or university. Academic writing is also used for publications that are read by teacher and researchers or presented at conferences. It has a formal tone and style, but it is not complex and does not require the use of long sentences and complicated vocabulary. Academic writing is clear, concise, focused, structured, and backed up by the evidence. The general purpose of academic writing is to present information in order to display a clear understanding of a particular subject. Its purpose is to aid the reader's understanding. It deals with the theories and causes of a given topic as well as exploring alternative explanations for these theories or events. Principles of academic writing. First, clarity. It refers to the meaning of what you are intending to communicate is perfectly clear. The readers does not have to read between the lines to guess what you are saying. Second, logical order. It refers to a logical ordering of information. Writers tend to move from general to specific. In an historical passage, the movement of information is chronological. That is from old to new. Chronological ordering is also logical when describing a disease, in that one would expect to learn of symptoms before learning of the treatment. Third is variety. Variety helps the reader by adding some spice to the text. It is achieved in part by using various methods of joining ideas. In addition to constructing sentences of various types and lengths, the writer should try to use synonyms when possible. Fourth is formality. Academic writing is formal in tone. This means that sophisticated vocabulary and grammatical structures are used. In addition, the use of pronouns such as I and contractions is avoided. Fifth, clear point of view. Academic writing is not just to inform and summarize, but also to present one's thoughts on those ideas, facts, etc. Therefore, it is essential for good academic writing to have a clear point of view. Single focus. As any academic writing has a thesis to develop, therefore, it should not unnecessarily divert to irrelevant and unimportant or even contradictory information or ideas. Planning. Academic writing is well planned. It usually takes place after research and evaluation, according to a specific person and purpose and plan. Unity. As its simplest, unity refers to the exclusion of information that does not directly relate to the topic being discussed in a given paragraph. In its broadest sense, an entire essay should be unified, that is within the paragraphs. The minor supports must support the major supports, which in turn must support the topic sentences. Each of the topic sentences must likewise support the thesis statement. Strong support and complete explanations. Each paragraph should have relevant support in terms of facts, examples, description, person, experience, etc. for the topic sentence and thesis statement. Moreover, one should provide explanations so that the reader do not have to think hard to understand the ideas and logic of the writing. Last is writing style. Style is the dress of thought. If a great idea is not presented effectively, it loses its greatness. Therefore, it is essential that one should try to figure out an unique style to write. Yes, I think these principles should be followed for academic writing. Academic writing is used for publications that are read by teacher and researchers or presented at conferences. An example would be a summary of an article or a report of the results of an experiment. I believe academic writing will be very effective when a proper outline took place in paragraphs or articles. An outline will not help us formulate our thoughts, but will make us aware of certain relationships between topics. It will help us determine the pertinent information to be included in our articles, essays, or paragraphs. And research papers and articles. Theses are written to obtain an advanced degree at a college or university. The language in their paper needs to be clear and words need to be chosen for their precision. A thesaurus is a good tool to help you pick just the right words to explain the issues in research. The point of view of the third person in academic writing should be to educate on the facts, not to support an opinion. The tone of writing in a formal way helps us to understand the research work properly and what is in the article. We are able to get to the point exactly. To make our article effective, we should use academic writing as our vocabulary. We'll increase and we will be able to write interestingly, full of facts and theses and with good, effective and unique words which people generally don't use. It is important for the academic writer to familiarize himself or herself with the principles of the academic writing by reading and analyzing other works so that the writer is best able to communicate his or her ideas. तो गाइज यहाँ पे हमारा आंसर कंप्लीट होता है. तो होप सो आप जल्द से जल्द अपने असाइनमेंट्स कंप्लीट कर रहे हैं. नई वीडियोस भी जल्दी ही अपलोड होंगी. तो चैनल को लाइक करें, सब्सक्राइब करें, शेयर करें और नीचे दिए गए